I'm so grateful to be able to come back into your homes to let you know the great things that God has for you. I want you to know that God is smiling on you today, family. Thank all of you for what y'all do on our channel every single day to help bring glory to God. We want to thank you for all of your acts of kindness, all of your support you give us from our products, praying for us, purchasing our book, Becoming a Master of Divine Consciousness. God is redirecting your destination. God is redirecting you. He's redirecting your life. Why is he redirecting your life? Because God has to take you the long way around, because there are enemies that have been seeking out, family, to hinder you, to prevent you, and to literally stop you from getting to the land that flows with milk and honey, the land of Canaan. You are being directed. And how is God directing you? God has so many ways to redirect our life to make sure that we get to the destination place. God oftentimes will redirect your life. He will redirect his children's lives through challenges, through tough times, through hardships, through trials, through tribulation. God sees things that you can't see. And God has heard conversations that you were never a part of. He has let you know through these challenges, through these hardships, that there's another way for you to get there. You're going to get to the destination place, and you're going to get there in one piece. And in that destination place, this is where God is going to bring so much peace in your life. God is going to bring so much rejuvenation in your life. God is going to bring so much happiness in your life. This is where God is going to literally restore your life. God has to get you to a place of restoration. And how does God get you to a place of restoration? God brings us to this beautiful place of being restored by weeding out things that shouldn't be in our lives, by weaning out people that shouldn't be a part of our lives. God will always cause the enemy to reveal their face. God will always cause the enemy to reveal his hand and the motives of the heart. You just have to listen closely. Pay attention. When you call a person a friend, you make sure they're your friend. Because some people are calling people friend and they're the enemy. And some are calling enemies friend, vice versa. But you are being redirected. God has taken a different course for you, because God knows, family, what lies ahead. So these are places in your life where you got to learn how to trust. And you can't go before God. You have to learn how to move in sync with God. And this is what God is teaching you. This is what God is teaching you along your journey. He's telling you to wait upon him, because he's going to renew your strength. You're going to run. You're not going to be weary. You're going to walk. You are not going to faint. People thought you were going to faint. People thought you were going to give up. People thought you were not going to get to the place where you said you were going to be. This is just a way that God will reveal to you that he has something better for your life. This is God's way of showing the adversary that no weapon that you form against my child is going to prosper. And every tongue that rises against it, you are the person that's going to condemn it. God never promised you and I that people's weapons wouldn't form against us. But he did tell us these weapons that have been devised against your life, against your sanity, your peace, against your children, your marriage, your business. He did say that every ploy, every plan, every scheme that is devised from the kingdom of darkness, that it will not prevail. I'm here to let you know the enemy will not prevail. The lie will not withstand the power of God. Nothing that the enemy does will be able to penetrate the blood and the power of the Lord, Jesus the Christ. You have been redirected. You have been taken the long way around to get to your destination place. Why did God take you a long way around? Because he had to humble you. God had to humble you. He had to let you remember when you get to the place of Canaan, where you were before you got to that Canaan. When God gets you to that beautiful place, you just have to stay humble. You can't stay lifted up in pride, because God is the lifter of our head. We don't want to be like Satan. We don't want to be prideful people, because without God, we're nothing. Without him, we can't do anything. You have a kingdom assignment. and there is an assignment against your assignment. But nothing that the Prince of Persia does will be able to withstand the power of God. Not one thing that people do will be able to withstand God's power. Nothing. The wealth that is due to you, you're going to gain the wealth. The restoration that is due to you, you're going to gain the restoration. Everything that the cankerworm, the palmer worm, and the locust has eaten, God is going to restore you. This is what God is doing. You are being restored. You are being placed in a position of power. You're going to be notarized. You're going to be in a place of notoriety, whether you want it or not. God is going to cause a spotlight to be upon you. God is going to cause people to look at you from afar to give you opportunities that you do. You are due great opportunities. You are due breakthroughs. You are due miracles. God is going to compensate you for everything that you lost. I want you to affirm today, this is my due season. What do you do? What did the enemy take from you? What did the enemy steal from you? What did the enemy take out of your life? What is that thing? What is it? This is your due season. Did you hear that? This is your due season. This is your now season. And God is going to do things for you that eyes haven't seen, nor ears heard. Neither has it entered into the heart of men, the things that God has prepared for you. God has great things for you. And there's nothing that no devil in hell can stop. Somebody disliking you is not going to be able to stop it. People being envious of your life, being jealous of your life, is not going to be able to prevent, hinder, or frustrate the plan and the will of God for your life. The more you are hated, the more blessing God was going to bestow upon your life. The more the enemy comes against you, the more God is going to cause his favor to rest upon your life. It is a blessing to be favored by God. But I want you to understand this. Comes favor, it comes with great responsibility, and it comes with great accountability. God is blessing you to be a blessing. You're being redirected. And God will redirect us to get us to the destination place through challenges, through these hardships, through storms, through things that are unfair, unfair circumstances, heartbreak, heartache, loss of any kind. God is placing you in a position to be restored. You are going to see the goodness of God upon your life. I let you all know this all the time because it's so true. I want you to hang in there because the best is yet to come for you. You haven't seen anything yet. The last breakthrough that God gave you is going to be bigger. The last blessing, the last miracle that God gave you, that he bestowed upon your life, the next one will be bigger and it will be better. God always increases our life. He always multiplies. But the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy your life. This is why you must stay girded up in prayer. You must stay sober-minded. You must be vigilant because God tells us, John 10:10, we have an enemy, we have an adversary. Although he is a defeated foe, he's already defeated. He comes to bring us suggestions. He comes to bring you illusions, and he's coming to bring you distractions. But stay prayed up so you can back down every distraction that he's going to send your way. He's going to send people in your life that's going to be a distraction. He's going to try to revisit past people in your life as a distraction. You're being redirected. Don't fight against it. Embrace it. You're going to get to the destination place. And when you see challenges, when you see losses, when you see tough times, hardships, this is what God is letting you know, that I am redirecting you to get to the destination another way. It doesn't matter what direction God takes to get you to that place. You're going to get to that place. I want you to say that. I'm going to get to that place. You're going to get to the place. You just got to believe in your heart. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. If you can believe it, you're going to have it. Just keep speaking the word of God over your life. Keep speaking life over every dead situation, and it's going to live. Whatever it is going to live. Speak, thus says the Lord, over that situation. This is Prophetess Nikki. Good to be here with you, family. Don't get scammed. I'm not reaching out to anybody. Just delete the replies and report the scammers. We love you.